Hi there, guys. Hope everybody's doing really, really well out there. Tom Quayle here, and I want to start by saying thank you so, so much for the response to the last video I did. That lazy first finger syndrome video. You guys were amazing in the comments, really positive feedback, and you know, some really great things to say as well, and some really great questions. So if you've not seen that video that I did last week on lazy first finger syndrome, in other words, this idea that your first finger can be the laziest finger on your left hand, especially when it comes to legato technique and how to fix that problem and why you should fix that problem, check out the link below. You'll find that video and you can watch it. But for those who've seen it so far and the amazing response, thank you so much, guys. That was really fantastic to see and very heartening. So yeah, let's continue with some of these videos. So for this week, there were a few questions that came up in that video, and I want to address some of those now. And I want to, well, in this video, and I want to address them by way of showing you one of the coolest things I think you can do on the guitar, especially with legato technique. And actually, over the years, as this has kind of crept more and more into my playing, I've been doing this particular style of legato since about 2007, 2008. And this particular facet of it, what I'm going to call palm muted legato, that you hear quite a few players doing these days, was coming in around that same sort of time. And it's partly down to the reason that I use this particular muting technique that I do. Now, let me just demonstrate what I mean by palm muted legato. And in this video, I'm going to talk about this palm muted legato, and I'm going to talk about muting in general. The reason being, one of the big questions that came up in the video, the previous video, this lazy first finger legato video, was to do with, if you're not using the first finger to mute the string below the one that you're on, which is classic technique, it's good technique and it's well taught technique, if I'm not doing that because my first finger is constantly coming on and off the fretboard as I'm playing legato on an individual string, how am I muting? What's my muting technique? How am I keeping the strings quiet? So we're going to talk about that quite a bit today. But before we do that, let me show you a little bit of palm muted legato so you can hear what it's supposed to sound like. And you'll hear, you know, quite a few players doing this these days. Greg Howe does it, Rick Graham, another big proponent of it. I do it a great deal. So it sounds a little bit like this, and I'm going to palm mute quite heavily. So just to say what's going on, I'm legatoing as normal, and then I'm palm muting at the bridge. So two things to state there as well that we'll address really quickly, another couple of questions from the previous video. I'm using a very low gain sound, as you can hear when I play softly. I can play chords and I'm on the bridge position here. If I go to the neck, so it's pretty clean, it's not like super, super overdriven, and I am not using any compression. Okay, now you guys can check this for yourselves if you have an Axe FX 3, because I'm using a preset that I created myself that is available on my website for free. So I'll link to that down below. And I'm using the Tube Screamer or TS-808 part or scene of that preset, and there's no compressor in there at all. You can hear. There's no compression, and you should still be able to do this technique. Now, of course, I'm doing it stupid fast. You can totally practice this really, really slowly. But I want to use this technique, this palm muted legato technique, to talk about muting in general for legato, because it's very different to general muting if you're doing, like, if you're doing power chord chugging, or if you're doing very kind of pick focused things like fast picking runs. My muting is different depending on what I'm doing on the guitar, and because legato is my primary form of execution, if you like — that sounded way more dramatic than it was meant to — it's my primary form of executing notes on the fretboard. This is where my sort of primary sense of muting comes from. So what am I doing? Well, normally when you play guitar, you sort of split the muting 50-50 between your left hand and your right hand. Now, when I'm playing legato, the vast majority of my muting is coming from the right hand. A little bit is coming from the left hand, but because of the nature of the left hand being very kind of, almost like it's dancing around the fretboard, there's less left hand muting going on, okay? Now this is the same for lead guitar generally. When you're playing chords, if I'm playing like a... If I'm going... If I'm doing that kind of thing, then obviously a lot of the muting is coming from the left hand because the right hand is doing so much motion. Now when the opposite is true, when the left hand is doing a lot of the motion, the right hand comes in and takes over the muting duties in a great kind of deal or a great number of cases. And that's what's happening here when I'm playing legato, especially this palm muted legato. Let's just park the palm muted legato for a second and put it to one side and talk about the wider issue of kind of muting when I'm dealing with legato. Because again, that came up in the previous video, a lot of people asking that question. So what I'm doing is basically 99% of my muting is coming from this part of my hand. So essentially, if you think about palm muting when you're playing power chords, which is going to sound super odd with this tone. If you can palm mute, then you can do the muting technique that I'm about to show you because it's basically the same thing. But the essence is that I'm just going to move to this camera here because I've kind of set this up so you guys can hopefully see what's going on. I'm not sure the focus is 100% right. I think the focus is somewhere around here, but hopefully you'll be able to see this. If I just put the pick down, the muting technique is basically, if you were to palm mute at the bridge, what you do is you come quite close to the bridge, but not on the bridge, and then you use this part of your hand to actually mute the strings. Now, the beauty of the way the hand is set up is that you can roll the hand across the strings to either mute just the lowest string, the E string in this case, or gradually roll the hand across as you want to mute more and more of the strings. Now, the reason this is super useful, I'm just trying to see if I can sort my focus out a little bit here. There we go, that's better. So, but the reason this is useful is because when I'm holding the pick, always when I play the guitar, I have some form of contact across the arm through here and then onto the strings, never on the bridge, because with a floating bridge like this, if I have contact on the bridge, I'm going to push the guitar out of tune. But in this case, I have contact on the low E string almost all the time, and I get rid of it if I'm actually going to pick the low E string for any reason. I don't want it palm muted. But within that process, this allows me to gradually bring the hand down onto all six strings. Now at this point, if I roll my volume up, obviously I can now pick all of those strings and they're all completely muted. I say completely muted, they're palm muted, so you still get pitch. If you mute with the left hand, you do still get some pitch, but because we're very close to the bridge, there's a lot of string free left to resonate here. So we do get quite a lot of kind of pitch ringing out in the background. That's okay, because when we play legato, we don't put a lot of energy into the string to start with. So what's actually happening here, as I'm actually rolling, or not rolling, but as I'm playing up the string in a legato fashion, you watch the right hand here, this hand waving at the camera. It's gradually rolling down using this part of the hand, just get that in focus somehow, back here, this part of the hand onto the strings like this. And this takes a lot of getting used to. And basically my hand is in this position almost all the time when I'm playing. So as I play a legato phrase, the strings below are all palm muted. And sometimes I'll catch the string. Now that's actually part of the sound and part of the technique that sounds quite nice. Now the cool thing is as you descend, you don't need to worry about this so much because if I just spin back around this way, this first finger is automatically, sorry, I'm looking up at the screen, this first finger is automatically muting for me. So, now this first finger, the natural curve of this first finger is resting down on the strings. Now again, this is pretty basic technique, okay? But when you ascend, you can't do that. So I'm rolling that hand, the right hand, across the strings as I go. And this is basically allowing me to mute each string individually. Now, this can lead to some issues if you string skip quite a lot. So if you play things like... But actually, because I'm a big Greg Howe fan, I actually like the sound of having the lower string of the string skipped motion muted and the upper strings free to ring out. So I like that sound. That's a great sound. So I don't mind having the lower strings of my string skipped pair muted with the right hand. But when I'm playing legato lines and I want the sound to be open, I will basically only mute the strings below the one that I'm playing. So again, let me show you that on this camera if I just move across again. So hopefully you guys can see. Again, apologies if the focus isn't quite spot on. So obviously look at this hand now and ignore the one that's out of focus. So I'm using all of this part of my hand to make sure that this is all muted below the strings that I'm actually playing at any given point. And that is allowing me to keep those quiet, basically. Now, I would practice this really, really slowly at first, because otherwise you're gonna be muting strings that you're playing all over the place. And like anything else that I do, I start out by having specific exercises to practice. So a good thing to start with would be 3 note per string scales. Let's say I'm in the key of G here. I always am for some reason on these particular kind of tutorial things. Let's say we take A Dorian. 3 note per string. Play through quietly and try to concentrate once you've got the left hand shape down and you're not having a lazy first finger. Again, watch the previous video if you need to check that out. Again, link below. Basically, practice rolling this bulk of the hand here down onto the next string as you go, keeping it muted. So you're trying to avoid this. All that noise behind. Now, I've not got a lot of gain here at all. If you're playing through a really gainy amp or a really gainy kind of patch on your modeler, you're going to have tons and tons of noise back there. You're aiming for when you get to the highest string, there's no noise, as opposed to this. My right hand is just floating free at this point. It's not actually doing anything. You should be able to stop at any point and not hear any noise at all. And that's all down to this basically being like a pressure valve. It's coming down and stopping all the noise as I ascend. Then when I come back down again, in order to play the strings and have them sing freely or kind of vibrate freely, I release that pressure valve. And then basically as I come back down again, my first finger acts as an anchor point. They're basically doing sort of this motion, the left and the right hands, in order to mute the strings above where I am. So that's how that works. Hopefully that answers a few questions, but this actually led to an amazing discovery years and years and years ago, which is that this term legato, now if this came up in the questions as well, somebody was referring, a few people were referring to the idea of legato meaning smooth and saying that legato by the nature of each note having this specific attack, because you kind of hammer on and pull off, the note gets a different transient each time, or it has a transient. Unlike with the piano, where you basically play softly, but the notes literally ring into each other ever so slightly. You can't do that on the guitar because each note has a distinct beginning and end point before the next note can be heard. So this sound, or this definition of legato, smooth, I wouldn't worry about it too much. Don't worry about the literal definition of this term legato. Or at least I wouldn't worry about it. When I say legato, what I'm talking about is the technique of hammer-ons and pull-offs. But within that realm of hammer-ons and pull-offs, utilizing that sound, of course it is a smoother sound than picking. If I was to pick a phrase, that is, by its nature, more disjointed and has more transients or more attack on each of the notes, because we are literally attacking each of the notes. But my legato sound is smoother. I had really bad muting there, let me do that again. However, That isn't really the reason that I do legato, although it's a great added benefit, if you like. But the reason I do legato is because I can't control my picking in any way, shape, or form in the same manner as I can my legato. So that's really, really important. Now, you guys might look at my picking there and say, man, you can pick. Of course, I have the raw speed, but I don't have the control in improvisation. And that's what I mean by my picking sucks, because someone asked that as well. So yeah, I don't literally mean my technique sucks for picking, but my ability to improvise sucks. So back on topic, essentially, as far as the legato thing goes, there's actually a wide spectrum of sounds that you can create with this technique, depending on what you do with the right and the left hands. So this sound can be very smooth, and all the notes can join almost exactly up together, which is what I was doing a second ago. So, or it can be very staccato if you palm mute hard. And there's all sorts of ranges in between. Depending on how hard you press when you're muting. So one of the cool things about this rolling technique is, as opposed to allowing the string to be open and freely ringing as you're playing on that particular string and then muting it as you move to the next one, you can mute it as you're playing it. And this gives you this staccato kind of legato sound. Now again, you shouldn't use those two terms together. Something cannot, in musical traditional language, be staccato and legato. Again, let me just reiterate, I'm talking about purely hammer-ons and pull-offs, okay? The physical technique of execution of the notes, not the sound that they make in the traditional kind of Italian terms that we use in music. So in this case, it's staccato sounding legato technique, okay? Let me put it that way. And again, the way I'm achieving that is by having this pressure valve of basically how much pressure do I want to put on the strings that I'm playing at the time in terms of this palm muted sound. Exactly the same palm muting, as I say, that you would use if you were playing power chords and chugging. How much pressure do I apply? And I can apply different amounts of pressure as I ascend and descend through the line. So it's super, super cool. If I grab some more overdrive here, slightly heavier sound. In this case, if I apply palm muting at certain points within the line, making sure that I'm applying it on the string that I'm playing at the time, and this takes a bit of experimentation generally, you want to watch the position of the right hand as well, because this might feel slightly awkward at first. So I'll show you from this view first and then turn round. Notice that I can change the amount of pressure that I'm applying. Okay, now I'm going to do this with something slightly different. I'll do it with the super Locrian scale, G super Locrian. So. Okay, let me show you that from this side as well. So if you watch the right hand as it's kind of moving around, again, apologies if it's not quite in focus. So it's a very, very cool sound. I absolutely love it. And the more gain you've got, the more staccato and kind of transient-like your legato will sound. So you've now got this range of sounds, like again, applying a valve, where you can essentially take a sound from being very, very smooth and very liquidy, all the way up to sounding almost as if it was picked. And this is particularly effective for ascending and descending scalar kind of lines, and also chromatic lines, and also arpeggios that kind of like keyboard style arpeggios. So again, one of the things I played there. And it's giving what is traditionally a non kind of attack based sound, legato, a very interesting attack. And it's something that I think people really gravitate towards because it's a slightly less guitaristic kind of sound. It gives you a spectrum of sounds that you can work with legato, as opposed the technique legato, of course, as opposed to this one-dimensional kind of sound that people tend to associate with the technique. So it's very, very cool. So there we go, guys. I hope that's useful. I hope that's answered a couple of questions as to how I'm doing the muting. I'm not doing this thing where I'm kind of pushing my first finger up against the string below to mute. All the muting, as far as ascending goes, as in going this way, comes from the right hand. And then as I descend, I'm actually, of course, always with the left hand, I'm muting the strings above where I am with my first finger, because it's lying flat onto those strings. But the ones below, I'm exclusively muting with my right hand. And of course, study the position of the right hand, see if that works for you. You don't have to do it the way I'm doing it. And in no way I'm suggesting that anything that I'm doing here is the way to do anything. It's the way that works for me, for my particular hand size, my particular guitars, the way I have them set up, the sounds I like. This probably wouldn't work so well if I was playing with masses and masses of gain, because I just wouldn't have the control. As I was moving up and down, I might get more noise than I might want. You may hear a little bit of kind of noise when I'm playing, but because of the amount of gain that I use, it doesn't really matter. I think you can get too obsessed with these things if you're not playing with super, super high gain. And of course, all the metal and djent guys out there, they really want things tight, so they use noise gates and things. That's not what this technique is about. It's a bit more organic. Again, don't take that as a better or worse kind of thing, guys. I love the djent sound. It's just that tight gated thing is not appropriate for this sound. There's a little bit more of an organic nature, allowed a little bit of noise. It's part of the characteristic. But generally, that's how the muting works. And I really implore you to experiment with that muted legato. So, as usual, guys, if you want more info on this technique, if you want to know how I'm constructing these lines, how come I'm able to improvise these lines and have this constant flow of notes without thinking everything in this video is improvised, obviously, I'm not writing these lines down for you, then you can check out my website. I'll leave a link below, and I've got some really extensive legato tutorials, Modern Legato Part 1, 2, and 3, and also my Ultimate Legato Practice Toolkit, which will give you 4 20-minute practice sessions that you can do that work on every single facet of this particular technique, and all the time-based information for this technique, all the subdivisions. A few of you guys have checked that out, so thank you very much for the support. So yeah, see what you think, guys. There's a ton of other lessons on there as well. Going to try and keep this content coming weekly. Next week, I think I've got a video coming with a very good friend of mine, David Beebe. We're going to discuss some fretboard visualization stuff, so I hope that's useful. And again, if you've not already, click the like and subscribe buttons below. Really appreciate it if you would hit those for me. And obviously hit the bell notification icon to make sure that you never miss any more videos as I upload them. Got some more demos coming soon as well. So thanks again, guys, and I will see you all in the next video. Bye-bye.